Who's that? What's with his hair sticking out?
We woke up, the whole side of his head sticking straight in, and I just got all over to lay down with that one piece, but not lay down. I sprayed it with, you know, the cement.
Do you go to see Taran, Mom?
Thank you.
But it's cracked, Mom. You might want to take it back. Mom, it was cracked. I was at the checkout, and I'm like, oh, I need one of those lenses of rock. So the girl just grabbed it and gave it to me, and I didn't notice till I grabbed it.
It's cracked.
Now, what Mom didn't get that she's going to get, of course, is a new $200 ring. Isn't in yet.
Teresa, I got a book. Peter and the Wolf. I love this. Thank you.
Perfect.
Hello, Granny. Come on, Granny.
Come on, Granny.
Granny's opening her present.
I have to open my present. Is this from you? Thank you. Ooh, cool. Big rock.
That's huge.
It might be. It's cute. This girl at work gave me this. She said she saw this and thought of me and she had to buy it. She hopes I don't have it.
So you're going, what in the heck?
I think it's a picture of the cat. No, it isn't. Oh my gosh. Look at that.
Joseph Smith.
Now, why would I remind her?
Wow, that's expensive.
Yeah, you should stick that down. I'll stick my whole arm. Yeah. Nice.
That is really nice. I was wondering where she's going to put hang. If she hanged every picture she had, there wouldn't be no walls left.
There's one part that is packed.
I mean, it looks like the one thing. This is from everyone, the boys, Teresa, and I didn't get to finish getting everything.
Oh, wow. Is that cool or what? Look, Mother.
That's huge, too. Is that for your trip to South Africa?
It is. I love it. I love these colors, you guys.
Yeah. You all picked it out, even Abe.
Thanks. Thank you. Thank you, Key. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay. I'm coming.
It's too cold down there.
Did you not start the fire?
No. I asked if I should.
Yeah, but lady.
Okay, Ronald.
No, Dad's turn. Dad, come sit here.
That is so long ago. Bring it up
here. Ready?
Wahoo!
Almost as good as Charl, not quite. That was so funny. Everybody was flipping out.
In the box down there.
Look at me.
Here, Mom.
Come back over here.
Oh.
You're on the right hand side.
Well, what do you know?
Gothic voices, hooray.
Hildegard, Dad.
Oh, Hildegard?
Yeah.
Yes. She's from the 10th century. She was a nun. So that is fabulous music.
The 10th century.
And then that other is
Could
the actual...
Sam Gardner.
Right.
Quite close.
Okay,
Charl. You get it. They're downstairs.
Lock the box.
Wow.
Bless the box. Aha. I've got a gap shoot. Is this my first ever gap shoot?
No. I doubt it.
Maybe.
That's nice, right?
No, it's not. Really nice. I'm sure.
I'll put it on now.
I've had other ones. Yeah. That's really nice, Teresa.
Thank you. Oh, well, that's not a newspaper, that's a package.
From Sharky. I guess strong people.
Oh,
like
I can match with Mom, huh?
Cool!
He's got a shamrock.
I'll have to go where you go.
My
Irish theme, big brass shamrock.
Oh, I better go get your presents, huh?
You want me to get them?
It's right by the TV, between the TV and the...
Right on by the side of the TV.
Okay.
I'll have to listen to Enya when I wear this. Dad. This is one?
Yeah, if you want
it. Oh, gee. I sure need these, Keith. I nearly bought some this week.
You'd have been another Charl. Hey, Charl, get his present behind him.
That's from Charl and I.
Thank you. No, I really need those. The ones I've got are
right
kind of hazardous.
For Dad. Did you get Dad's?
This is for Dad. And also...
This is for
Quasimodo.
Well, thank you, Grandma. This makes my life twinkle. Thank you.
You're
welcome.
Hey, Mom. Is this a hint?
No, I thought you were planning on it.
Planning on leaving?
See?
And
you have to unzip it. There's something inside.
Mom got something else. I didn't know where her stocking was, so I put it in her purse.
Well, let's see.
Thank you, Grandma. 168 pictures.
Pack of film.
You got $5, Timo. You can go buy
some. Oh, meat. This is
he
great.
He doesn't need anything. Maybe Play-Doh.
What is it?
The Education of the Heart. Oh. BYU professor has done this.
Where did I see that before? Nice.
Maybe just walk through.
I got
the guy that I'm learning.
I guess you have to
wait
for Christmas.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be really good.
Thank you.
Dad, you have to look in your suitcase.
Oh, I do?
Mm-hmm.
Before my trip.
You're going to get a kick out of this one.
Does this go in the toilet and it whistles while you work?
No.
Did you buy another one?
No, I found it.
Oh, you found it?
What is it?
He couldn't find out where he'd done with it.
The light fixture I wanted to put down in the furnace room.
I found it, so I put it in.
His stocking.
This is a suppository. thanks. Handy dandy stuff.
He was with me. My father.
Oh, those are cool. What was it? Leatherman?
Not there, Ron. This is the zipper part on the outside.
Figure it out. You've got a booger coming out of your nose. I see it.
Huh?
Really?
This is the missed part.
Look inside.
Yay!
This is a bathrobe.
Mm-hmm.
This is for going down to the pool. Elegance.
I'll get it out.
Yay! Ready for the dip.
Shall we go find it? Yeah. The gargoyle?
Thank you.
Okay.
Made in Turkey.
That's where they make.
We'll go downstairs and find it.
Find what?
The gargoyles.
Mm. We shouldn't go down there until we've heated it for a while. I don't think it's healthy.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Oh, Teresa, will you read us a book? We have a book that I bought for Christmas.
That one, The Bright Christmas? Right here, Teresa.
Oh,
There is some runs on your
seal. And one runs on the golden rule, huh? Do unto others what you are hoping they will do unto you.
I don't think.
I know she wants one of these.
Well, she told us, I asked her what you wanted, you know. And she said, oh, he'd really like one of those.
I have never even mentioned
travel
in
things.
My life.
No, but you guys saw them.
We had more suitcases than we could handle.
No, you don't.
That's the point.
The ones we have are too many.
They all may be thrown away.
Yeah.
I've always been an angel, always. I've never needed a clock or a calendar because here, where I live, there's really no need, no time at all. So I guess it's strange for me to remember a certain night. But I do remember because that night was very different from all the others, ever. That night, the great truth came to the earth once and for all. People sometimes think that Christmas came suddenly, one holy night. I know better. Other things came first. Amazing things, beautiful things, important things, and I saw them all. Because when a message goes from heaven to earth, it's not a letter, it's an angel. And the angel doesn't just carry the message, the angel is the message. We had brought light and truth to the earth before that night. Why? The earth needed to be ready. We sang to Moses, and then Moses was given commandments that brought great truth closer. We sang to David, and when David saw the great truth come to earth through his own family, he sang too, psalm after psalm after psalm. We sang to Isaiah, and Isaiah saw that the great truth would come as a child. He would be called Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor. But still, earth seemed dark and far away until that night. That night, a light was lit like no other. I remember the star in the sky above Bethlehem and the songs and the messages we had ever brought to earth. They all led up to that one night. They lit up the sky. We were watching over Joseph and his wife when the innkeeper sent them away. We knew that where they were going. We knew they would be safe and warm in the quiet of the stable. In the hills above Bethlehem, I remember the faces of the shepherds looking up. It was time for the great truth to shine on the earth. Nothing could have stopped it, and nothing could have kept us from singing about it. And sing we did, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. For unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And nothing could have kept those shepherds from walking through the night to see the child. We lit the path, and like sheep they had been lost, the shepherds found their way. And like sheep that have been lost. And Mary, I will always remember her face. When she heard us sing, Mary knew that this child laid in a manger was bringing the great truth. She knew it in her heart, and it shone in her face that night. Earth now had a heavenly light of its own, and it made me sing louder and sweeter. Our song was like the smile of God. And the light and the music and the angels were the same thing. And Jesus smiled too. And the light shined in the darkness, and there was no night there, I remember. Here where we live, there's really no time at all. It's just now, the day in heaven. And right now in the day in heaven, it is still that first Christmas night. Once I sing a song, the song never stops. It's like a star that burns forever. Christmas is the brightest and the happiest song I ever sang. And the star is still shining, and I am still singing, and the earth is still singing back.
Is that at BYU?
Yeah.
That's from Mom to Teresa?
No, it's Mom.
It's from Mom to Mom. I just thought, okay, now these things I got, it's for everybody to share. This is a funny book.
You know you're a Mormon if.
And it has these funny things.
You know you're a redneck.
And
thanks, Grandma.
more random acts of kindness, the cute little quotes. And then I got this for our family.
I read, you know, on BYU Today, they had that article about, you know, you got a sign.
Yeah. Didn't yours, wasn't yours?
I wasn't going to stand in line to get it signed. The line was a half an hour to get through the line just to get it signed.
Oh, well, later there was no line.
Right. Well, he just did that. He did extras. So.
And then this is, I don't, anybody wants to borrow this to make pizza?
I have one.
What?
I have one of those.
You like it?
I never use it.
You don't? You can make cookies on it and everything.
My what companion, Mona Boggs, she gave me it when I got married.
It has that thing in it?
Yeah, remember?
And you never use stone. It takes out the moisture so it browns evenly, like if you're doing pizza.
Right.
You put it's it on here and it
remember
makes
Remember the
it
gourmet
crusty.
Pizza kit? Mm.
Yeah, well, I didn't know it had that piece in it because I've never seen that part of it.
It's not as big. It's like 2/3 the size. Yeah.
How's your hand doing?
It takes the moisture.
Is it a ceramic?
Uh-huh, it's a ceramic.
Well, evenly, it doesn't make it dried out, but it evenly cooks
instead
it
instead of
that
sweating
way.
Underneath where it's on.
Oh.
Yeah, so it has a nice crust.
Yeah, so it, but you can put, I got this size because you can put cookies on it.
Right.
Or other things.
Huh.
It's going to sound like scratching your nails on chocolate.
Boy, I kind of like it.
Kind of like nails scratching on chocolate.
Makes pizza dough. So you never use, does yours come?
No, it's not Pampered Chef, it's some other company. Oh. It's a mail order something, because she had it sent to us when we got married. It had, I have one of those wooden things, Mom, you know, to stick it in the oven on one of those, you know, wooden paddle.
Oh, yeah?
And I have a round, a regular round pan as well.
Wow.
She gave with it. And a pizza cutter. I mean, it was like, and it has a bunch of recipes.
Dude, that's very good.
But they're too, they had too many things in them, you know? I mean, they're gourmet. I mean, there's a gourmet pizza. And I'm like, well, my kids don't care.
Who gets to play the CD first?
Me.
No,
paper,
I do.
Rock, scissors.
How you doing, Charl?
Are you sick?
No.
Sick of being awake.
You didn't get what he wanted.
Yeah, he only got doubled everything he wanted.
Because he bought it for himself before Christmas.
Thanks, Mother.
That's one way to make sure you get it, buy it.
No, I said maybe he learned his lesson.
Oh, sorry. Take that.
Not lucky.
Yep.
It's just Earth Cap got all these mission. You know, she was a mission person. Uh-huh.
Mission matron.
And when you worked for Earth Cap, she interviewed him.
46.
So she like interviewed him and
take your stuff back. All the stuff.
You see that guy wrote a book on what I wish they'd told me before I went on my mission?
Yeah, John, by the way.
No, he's like totally making all this money. I'm like, I could have written that book myself. Everybody could have written that book. I'm like, I can't believe that. It's not bad.
What book did you write?
Everything, what I wish I'd known before I went on my mission.
But they didn't teach me.
Yeah, or something like that.
Yeah, there's so much stuff they don't tell you.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't have known, I wouldn't have went. No,
well, you, I mean, you think about it, though. I mean, some, I think some people wouldn't go if they knew how hard it was.
Realistic.
I mean, some people, they just would not even attempt it.
Right.
You know, they just hear these homecoming talks and don't hear about how difficult it can be.
Sometimes it seems so tedious.
Yeah, sometimes you don't feel like there's any progress. Like,
you don't feel like anyone cares or appreciates what you're doing. No one listens.
Cat's naked.
You ever told me my companion would run away in the night? I'd want to run away. I don't know where he was. I just dreamt we find him in that one drowned or something next morning.
Your companion would run away?
I wouldn't even drive because he didn't have a driver's license.
He wanted to run away?
He did.
Oh.
But he wanted to drive and I wouldn't allow him to because he didn't have a driver's license. Some members left us a car for a month. They were gone and they asked us to take care of him. He get mad at me and dig his nails in my arms because when I was driving.
What a dork. That looks nice, Dad.
It's
simple that
it looks.
That sticker off.
It's so light. It's so light.
Here, Dad. Here's a sticker on the pocket.
July. Local band?
Yeah. Well,
yes,
what's it
called?
No wonder you want to go to the best band in
the town.
What? It's like I can
set you free.
I don't know, it's big. Yeah. They're round.
basketball if you want to go.
Yeah, that'd be fun. Especially basketball.
Right now?
Yeah. I thought you said at 3.
Isn't it
2
o'clock?
Yeah.
Oh.
I thought it was. Let's go. I thought it was. 2 o'clock. Let's see if it's
got your board. Going?
A cup in your baking soda overnight, there's a good job on cleaning oil and grease from a garage floor.
It's one of the early ones where it tears fast down.
One of them will say one thing and the other one will say something like totally opposite how. Like one will say he looks like a man of compassion and all this. He looks like he's filled with hormones. And one of them said that.
A spray painted piece of wax paper is not a good replacement for a broken brake light.
Dang it.
I had no idea there were this many boards out.
I had no idea there could be a whole catalog or magazine about snowboards.
Oh, stop it.
there was one in the bookstore. It was like $7. It was so big. Most of it was just pictures.
There's a brand out there called Goddess Snow Bunny. It must be a women's snowboard company. How long's your board, Keith?
What?
How long's your board?
146.
Yeah.
Huh? Where are you
going to
put it? In your room?
Oh yeah, that would be good.
That would
be good.
I'll see you
here.
Huh?
Is moving out?
On the tram. Buy these?
Those? Pet boys?
Meant for a car. Mine might be too big for me. Huh?
No, because it says Trooper on there, doesn't it?
I never saw Trooper. I found these Zuzu starters.
Try it first, though, Dad, because that is Zuzu's.
Oh, good. That's all we got.
Oh, good. I really need these. Those ones are good in there.
Yeah.
What shoes do you wear?
Nice heavy ones.
I nearly bought some this week.
Tragedy. Because I could not think of anything else to get yet.
Because
so I go, that would be perfect.
What's his name? Chicken.
That was the only place we didn't go to. We went to AutoZone.
Huh? I see this board I'm getting. I'm getting it.
Pet Boys had the best.
For like less than the wholesale cost. This new board. And just looking at the schematics on it, it's only 151 centimeters. And it's got a 30.5-inch nose and tail, which is like an inch wider than most other ones on here.
And then
tradition when you graduate,
the inside cut is at 25.4.
No, I got mommy.
It's 2.5 inches in. That's a huge side cut.
Yeah, but
I think I'll carve hard off that.
My board?
Well, oh, I don't see yours in here.
I'd be surprised since it's a local store.
Yeah, it's just
a sand. Oh, it's just a store, mate?
Yeah, there's...
They just put their graphics on it then, probably.
It's not clear, it's fuzzy. I can't turn it up.
Wonder who made it? What if we can find out from looking at it?
You can't turn yours up very loud anyways, though.
It's terrible.
Well, because... it's been sick since you live in a condo, don't
you? I know there's no one else on my
computer. Someone else has a stereo in your apartment?
Becky does.
Did you get lots of presents?
Ghetto Blaster. See, that's the thing. I don't know if I want to just go buy another Ghetto Blaster. I think I'd rather get a stereo. And I don't just want any stereo.
Huh?
I think I want
to... Brooklyn?
Oh.
When I can repair TV and everything.
Timo? Timo?
He's looking for his Brooklyn.
Timo, you want to go read? Do you want to eat some lunch? Because I gave him some water. And you just got down on my
feet. Gangbanger, look at you, got your pants pushed to your knees.
That looks so down, huh? Mm-hmm. They wear their pants, I think.
One pen.
You know, this is still going.
Is it?
Yeah. Hey, say hi! Aren't those pretty lights?
Yeah.
What's that? Okay, we're going in.
Don't ever do it again, okay?
Okay, Jess.
I can't keep track of both of them.
Beautiful, isn't it? Isn't it fun? Isn't Christmas time fun? There's all these neat things to come see. Wait, Taran, you're dragging me. Hi, Timo. Hi, Dad.
Hi.
Let's see Taran. Where's Taran? There he is. That's all.
Okay.
Hi, Mommy!
Where's the soldier?
Right here by the drum.
I don't see a soldier.
Thank you. This is our living. Mm-hmm. Christmas. Okay, does a neat trick.
You know what this means.
Unless I can see in the mirror. Move. I'm gonna put music on. Christmas music. And I'll just like do a narration on paper or something. Or maybe I'll dub over a narration.
Did you get, is there room from right there in that there looking in that way you see the
curtains all wanked out there.
It doesn't look like Sunday, does it? Is that their car?
It's
Tim's
Whose
mom's car.
Is that anyway?
Sister Pew's.
What?
Sister Pew.
There's a Russian hat on.
He has his Finney's hat.
What are you doing?
They can't make it through that smoker, Charl.
There's nothing here.
See from here. I thought the silly thing was on, it wasn't.
It hasn't been on at all. So we don't know how. Look.
I took shots before they started.
It's like a bad winter storm.
Thank you.
by the loop.
I don't think I'll go make a snow angel today, Taran. Too cold.
I got in the right spot.
Rochelle.
An adverb? Mm-hmm. Sloppily.
Okay. Okay. Geographical location.
Down. Here, over here. So. She had something. Some conflict that she couldn't come tonight, and Laurel, it's Laurel's anniversary. Oh! And so they were celebrating.
Hey, it's okay.
Was it bad?
He came in. Well,
but, yeah. Unless you want to pick them out.
Stop.
Okay. What I have here is Ben's version of how they met and got married and Dee's. And you tell me which one you think is right. Okay? Here's the first one. I don't know whose is whose. Dee first met Ben late last May when a friend of hers named Weston, who happened to be one of Ben's creepy friends, invited Dee, Ben, and another girl to see the movie Born Free. It was a true double date because they just switched bears all night. Dee's first impression of Ben was that he was very splendid, and actually she was more interested in Ben. He's schizophrenic, I guess, who she already knew. But she thought Ben was hot to run with and liked his balloon. And then he used to do a lot of the same things that Weston and she did. She never expected anything like a megabyte would come out of this new friendship. Ben's first impression of Dee was that she was exceedingly yellow and pretty. Someone he could drink with and have fun skipping with. Everyone had lots of fun that night, and Ben and Weston decided to do something with these seven girls again. They're schizo too. So in September, Ben was getting ready to work them to a going show. When he and Weston got a castle from the girls inviting them on a luxurious lawnmower trip on the same day as the show. So they did both and then went to Shangri-La to see the movie Strictly Ballroom. After that, Dee and Ben just kept running into each other and studied for finals. Their mutual lack of interest in glue sticks was another common bond. Common bond, how about that? Ben had mentioned mentioned that he was a chapstick for Humanities 101 class. And since Dee liked dancing, he talked her into jumping the class. Since it was her last thing to do, and Ben's only thing to do, he would take her to Zimbabwe afterwards and talk. In June, Ben wanted to show a tape of an ice skating tribute to Dee and some of her other friends, and after watching Bed of Roses at her place, everyone else left, and Ben and Dee watched the tape he brought. And then he started noticing that something large was going on, and that maybe they weren't just kisses after all. From then on, decided to date sloppily. Dee then left for China for 21 months, and her absence seemed to make the escalator grow funnier, because after her return, things just progressed naturally until one night, when Dee was hoping Ben would ask her to ski with him. In the middle of watching the movie Goodbye, Mr. Chips, he just asked if she wanted to marry him, and she said, uh-huh. Then chickened out and said, stop. Then worried that he would change his meatball, but she was out of luck. He wanted her, so she agreed, and the rest is toenails. I'm not sure who said that, but okay. Here's the other one. Dee first met Ben late last March when a friend of hers named Weston, who happens to be one of Ben's good friends, invited Dee, Ben, and another girl to see the movie Muppet Treasure Island. It was a true double date because they just switched pairs all night. Dee's first impression of Ben was that he was very strange, and actually she was more interested in Weston, who she already knew. But she thought Ben was fun to hang out with and liked his attitude, and that he liked to do a lot of the same things that Weston and she did. She never expected anything like a wedding would come out of this new friendship. Ben's first impression of Dee was that she was exceedingly pretty and weird, someone he could get along with and have fun hanging out with. Everyone had lots of fun that night, and Ben and Weston decided to do something with these two girls again. So in April, Ben was getting ready to invite them to a folk dancing show when he and Weston got an email from the girls inviting them on a tandem bike trip on the same day as the show. So they did both and then went to Weston's to see the movie Strictly Ballroom. After that, Dee and Ben just kept running into each other and studied for finals. Their mutual lack of interest in school was another common bond. Ben had mentioned that he was a TA for a folk dancing class, and since Dee liked dancing, he talked her into taking the class. Since it was her last thing to do and Ben's only thing to do, he would take her home afterwards and talk. In May, Ben wanted to show a tape of an ice skate tribute to Dee and some of her other friends. And after watching Sleepless in Seattle at her place, everyone else left, and Ben and Dee watched the tape he'd brought. And then they started noticing that something weird was going on and that maybe they weren't just friends after all. And from then on, they decided to date in earnest. Dee then left for Louisiana for 2 months, and her absence seemed to make the heart grow fonder, because after her return, things just progressed naturally till one night when Dee was hoping Ben would ask her to marry him. In the middle of watching the movie Singing in the Rain, he just asked if she wanted to marry him, and she said yes, then chickened out and said, wait, then worried that he would change his mind, but she was out of luck. He wanted her, and so she agreed, and the rest is history. She's going to run hook up to somebody here.
I thought they're going out.
Now you've got
Say, have him save that so we can make her wear a stupid hat. I had to.
Huh? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Did we wear a hat last time? We had everything on a plate.
Yeah.
And I had a hat to wear. Somebody writing down a food list.
My mom bought me cake stuff when I was a kid, and I just learned.
Some books just created.
Books and materials. Let's have lots of temper tantrums. You can ask them about them. Lots of cake. Big Tam, lots of birthdays.
Oh, that's cute. Oh, nice.
We'll take a picture. Don't take a picture.
Well, he can sit out.
I like this little bear with it. Is this not a bear? Yep.
Whoops, I let it drop.
Yes, he is.
Well, I should take a picture when you're filming.
No, that's fine. That is awesome.
That is pretty much a bear, so.
That is perfect.
Thank you guys so much. When's she going through?
You're supposed to be over there.
I have you. I have you. I have
to be taking a picture of all the families.
That's your assignment.
Us three.
Oh,
COO. You also. Maybe I would have got first because he's not. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, just leave them there and I'll just, you all gather up.
I just tricked him. I'm like, go vacuum all upstairs and the basement. He just barely got up.
So
here's
we
my
almost,
camera.
Oh, okay. I was already starting to take pictures with
okay,
mine.
Okay. Well, what I'm doing is I'm going to have everybody do, every family do one of these. I sent one to each of your siblings. So you guys can start doing this. I'm going to send him over when it's like probably about 20 to 5 and tell him that.
Okay.
They're noisemakers, so we can lock the door.
Let that fight
get back. But then I will
do that.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to count to three. 1, 5, 9, 2, 3. Paying attention to me?
So, Taran would go somewhere.
I'm not counting,
okay.
Right?
I'll take
my count, Erica.
Because
today,
actually,
How about green cheese? Green cheese. Can you take your tongue out? Then you get up and chase me on the circle.
try and touch me before I get around to where she was sitting and sit down. So I make it, and now she's in, and she goes around and sees that dust and gargoyle. If she touches me before I make it, then I sit in the canvas on the pot.
Go, Carson! 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 stick. The way it works is you play the limbo music. You hold the stick up here and you have to try and go underneath the stick without crawling. We'll have Steph really show how to do this.
Get yourself a little. in a circle. Let's go around. Falling down.
Yeah.
Hawaiian pineapple and candy bacon. Who wants cheese?
I don't know these
kinds are. You don't want to. Pepperoni or cheese?
Josh, which kind did you want this kind too?
No, I want mushrooms.
Mushrooms? Do I have any mushrooms?
Did you wash your hands?
Don't have mushrooms.
I'm going to help you.
You want more pepperoni?
Actually, you
can have mushrooms.
No. Everybody have pizza? You got some?
Two times, because you're two.
Hit harder.
Good job.
Good job, T.
I'll do it.
Okay, go get the stick, too.
I'll do it.
Let me get him. Because I didn't get a good shot of him. That's okay. Okay, go give it to Ashley. Let Ashley have a turn now.
Get it harder. Hard. Good job.
Okay, let's team will have a turn.
Thank you.
me ask those of you to stand who are returned missionaries in the LDS Church. Let me ask those of you to stand who are bilingual, at least speak one other language besides. Let me ask those of you to stand who are married and have children. Now let me ask those in the audience to stand who are spouses and children of the graduates. Let me ask parents or grandparents of our graduates to stand. I appreciate his being willing to go to bat to keep that assignment. As a young man, Elder Staley received his bachelor's degree from Utah State University, and then his master's degree and his PhD degrees from the University of Illinois. Elder Staley was affiliated with Allied Mills, Inc., a subsidiary of Continental Grain Company, in senior management positions, including president, from 1969 through 1977. In 1977, Elder Staley joined the board of directors of Continental Grain, where he served as executive vice president, president in 1997 as CEO, continuing the role as chairman for a little while longer. Elder Staley has had broad international experience, having directed Continental Grain's businesses in 57 countries on 6 continents. His service with outside organizations has been wide and varied, including a number of internationally related groups and corporations. He is chairman of the U.S.-China Business Council and director of the National Committee on United States-China Relationships, the American-Chinese Society, and the U.S.-Russia Trade Council. He is also past chairman of the International Business Leaders Advisory Council for the mayor of Shanghai and the past chairman of the board of the American Feed Industry Association. He serves as trustee of the American Graduate School of International Management, board of directors of the International Executive Service Corp, and the Points of Light Foundation. He is a member of the Council on Foreign Relations in New York and a director of the New York City Partnership. Elder Staley has served on a number of board of directors, including Prudential Life Insurance Company, Bankers Trust, Conti Financial Corporation, Continental Grain, and Freestone's Medical Care AG. He has served in a number of positions in the church, including most recently state president and 2 previous state presidencies, as well as 2 bishoprics, president of an elders forum, and as assistant state trade council. Elder Staley and his wife, Afton, reside in New Canaan, Connecticut. They have 4 children and 11 grandchildren, all of whom reside in Connecticut. Don is not aware of the next part of this program. He thinks he came here solely to be our convocation speaker. Nevertheless, in recognition of his many achievements and for his distinguished service, it is an added pleasure to announce that the Marriott School of Management has selected Elder Donald L. Staley as its 1997 recipient of the Jesse Nye Distinguished Service Award. This award was first given in 1961. Elder Staley is the 29th recipient of this prestigious award. The plaque. University Marriott School of Management is pleased to present Donald L. Staley the Jesse Nye Distinguished Service Award in recognition of Elder Staley will now speak to us on the important topic, challenges and values for tomorrow's global managers. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Elder Donald Staley.
Thank you very much, Dean Skousen.
I'm honored and humbled with the invitation to join with you on this very special day. And I'm deeply surprised, but greatly appreciative of that recognition just given to me. My hearty congratulations to each one of you graduates today on this special milestone in your life. I think also a special tribute goes to you, parents, wives, grandfolks, all who are involved, who have been supported and encouraged these young people in their pursuits. I was impressed as you stood representing the various categories that the dean had outlined. And I'm impressed with the numbers of you who have been on missions, who have bilingual opportunities, and who are internationally oriented in your activities, because that's very much of what I want to talk about today. You're entering a new chapter in your life, and it's just about to begin for each one of you as you go forward. As I think about the opportunities and the challenges that lie ahead, I admit today to a bit of envy. Envy in the positive sense, because I'm so excited about the dynamics of the world in which we live and the opportunities that it will provide for each one of you. Opportunities for personal growth and success.
Frederick Benson. Holly Deanne Allison Blair. Tamara Harris Barney. Carter S. Brown. Virginia Carolyn Child. Destin Troy Chipman. Melinda Christmas. Matthew Jefferson Church. Uinta Clark. Wendy Gillensgag Hornaby. David Scott Higby. Melinda Giles Higby. Spencer J. Hoops. Jackson M. Hoops, wife of Spencer J. Hoops, B.S. in biology, composite teaching, and so on. Edie Renee Johnson. Jason Gage Jones. Michael Aaron Judd. Sean David Lishman.
Jason!
Louw Christmas Lindsay. R. Charl Cole. Okay. Peter James Melanson. Stephanie Walker Horn. Jason Todd Morris, husband of Stephanie Walker Morris, B.S. in zoology. Monica Newton. Matthew Rockwell Netteson. Brian Spencer Neal. Brandon Reed Neal. Ryan Glenn Patterson. Sterling Justin Heathcraft. Jason Andrew Walston. Emily Jane Richards. David Lee Robinson Jr. Scott Willis Sumption. Jennifer Rebecca Updyke. Kenyon R. Burchell. Malia
Reeves. Gregory Scott Little. Local Edward Sweeney.